हैप्पी डे चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज़ 9th स्टैंडर्ड सोशल साइंस इकोनॉमिक्स यूनिट 1, अंडरस्टैंडिंग डेवलपमेंट रेस्पेक्टिव मेजरमेंट एंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी। ओके, अंडरस्टैंडिंग डेवलपमेंट, ओके, रेस्पेक्टिव मीन्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू एंड एस्पेक्ट्स, ओके, एंड मेजरमेंट एंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी ऑफ डेवलपमेंट। ओके, इस we are going to learn about to know the meaning of development from different perspective, to know the indicator of economic development, understanding the meaning of economic development, and to know the policies of sustainable development. Okay, let us see the introduction. The word development, okay, what is development? When we progress from primary to high school, your class teacher listen to you all, your achievement, listen to your will and goal. They also asking perfect question in your class, what do you want to become, what is your desire, what do you decide to be in the future. I am asking the same question for you. What would be your reply? Yes, you have the particular goal, progress. If you have taken any step towards it, that is called development. Okay, yes. Today we are going to discuss about understanding development. Okay, if we talk about any field, education, agriculture, okay, any field, education, in the field of agriculture or another thing, okay, the development for achieving particular goal, okay, the development means for achieving particular goal, whatever we take a step is called development. Okay, if you desire, if you want to become doctor or engineer, how much you have tried to become it or achieve that goal, okay, that is called development. Okay, if you keep on changing from it is keep on changing from person to person and time to time. Okay, so listen here, the word development is used widely. Okay, it refers to the progress of particular field or particular person. Okay, it refers to the progress of particular field, that means a field, the a field is means education or agriculture, or you want to become engineer or doctor, scientist in particular field. Okay, yes, similarly the economic progress of a country is known as economic development. Okay, however the interpretation of the concept development keeps on changing. Okay, the concept keeps on changing time to time from person to person. Okay, and its meaning gets extended further. Okay, yes, let us move the next one. Let us try to image what development means to different people. Okay, what are the different image the development means in different people. Yes, yes, development means it growing process a needed direction. Okay, growing process in needed direction, way of moving forward. Okay, way of moving forward, not doing same mistake twice. Okay, it part of daily life. Development means advance, development means grows within, never ending the process, bettering yourself, freedom to grow, progress and improvement. Development means improvement, okay? Yes, these are the different images, different imagine of development means of different people, okay? Now we are going to talk about a particular person in economic development. You might admire someone, okay? You might admire someone, anybody, okay? Anybody who is a particular person, okay? Tata Birla, Ambani, okay? Yes, now we are that is similarly a particular person, okay? I think about, so there are is some similarity. Okay, the same way talk about nation development in economy, nation developing towards in economy called economic development. Okay, yes, different perspectives about development. Different perspectives means what I told you, view, a point of view. Okay, yes, every human being has an ambition. Okay, or desire, what he want to become, okay? Say some are select medicine, some are select engineering, some are select business, okay? Yes, every human being has an ambition, goal or desire of his or her own to achieve progress in life, okay? Similarly, we have ideas about how a country should be progress, okay? If our thinking turns towards progress and about the ways to achieve the many goals for progress, it leads to development, okay? So we do something about in the way of progress, okay? Achieve our goal, that is called development, okay? Yes. Yes, how much you have tried to become, okay? How much you have tried to become or achieve that goal, okay? It is the progress is called development, okay? Next we move the next one, okay? From the above chart, you will notice the other than income, okay? People seek freedom to grow on their own, okay? Development refers to the improvement of quality of life, such as higher income, better education, better health, better nutrition, less poverty and more equal opportunity, okay? So the term economic development refers to the overall growth of all sectors. All sector means there are different kinds of sectors, okay? Primary means agriculture, mining, okay? These are the primary sector. And secondary means industrial sectors, tertiary, and these are the different sectors, okay? So economic development refers to overall growth of all sectors of the economy by adoption of new technologies, okay? Economic development improves the living standard of people as well as status of our country, okay? Indicators of economic development, okay? A major indicators, determining the development measures, okay? So they are the indicators of economic development, okay? What are the indicators of to measuring the level of economic development, okay? Yes, that are net national product, that NNP. Next, per capita income, purchasing power parity, okay? Purchasing power parity, PPP, and human development index, okay? Yes, these are the indicators to measure the level of economic development. Net national product, NNP, per capita income, PCI, purchasing power parity, PPP, and human development index, okay? Next, we are going to talk about national net national product. Okay, net national product is considered as a true measure of national output. It is also known as national income. Okay, a rise in per capita income means and rise in aggregate real output. Okay, hence this is a better indicator of our national income for measuring development. Okay, for measuring country's development, its income is considered to be one of the most important factor. Okay, for measuring of country's development, country's economic development, income is most important factor. Countries with higher income are considered to be a developed. Okay, and then those with lesser income. So income itself is considered to be one of the indicator of economic development. Okay, then we move on per capita income. Okay, yes, per capita income. However, for comparing the development of various countries, okay, total income is not satisfactory measure. Okay, however, we can comparing the development of various countries, total income is not satisfactory measure. Okay, since countries have different population, comparing total income will not be suggestive. Okay, of what an average person is likely to earn. Okay, as people in one country are better than of the other in a different country. Okay, so the average income is calculated by dividing country's total income by its total population. Okay, yes, the average income is calculated by dividing the country's total income by total population. The average income is also called per capita income. Okay, per capita income means per head. Okay, in for example, I give you a simple example. Okay, in our class 15 students in our class. Okay, we will collect amount serving for poor people. Okay, we collect some amount, we try to distribute amount ourselves. Okay, when we collect money from you, we did not take any account, we collected money in the fund box. Okay, at last we got about 50,000 rupees. Okay, 50,000 rupees. Okay, how many of it? We are 50. Okay, we collect 50,000 bulk amount and don't know how much each person has given. We don't know how much is each person has given. Okay, we try to give an average amount to each and everyone. Okay, that's called per head. Okay, each and everyone amount we received 1,000 rupees. Okay, yes, this is called per capita income. Okay, some might given 2,000 or 5,000 and some might have sponsor 100 rupees or 50 rupees. Okay, yes, but at behind we distributed average amount 1,000. This is called per capita income. Okay, so 50,000 we divided 50 people, each and everyone received 1,000 rupees. Right, yes, we might have some people earn 10,000, some of them were earn 50,000, some people will earn lakh, some people were earn 5 lakh or 10 lakh. Okay, yes, some people don't earn any at all. Okay, but at the behind we calculated national income. Okay, and the population for the country. So each and every person how much earn daily money, that's we talk about per capita income. Do you clear? Yes. So the average income is calculated by dividing the country's total income by its total population. The average income is also called per capita income. Calculations on the per capita income of all countries are calculated only in dollar. Okay, in order to compare international level. Okay, do you clear? Next we move on purchasing power parity. Okay, purchasing power parity. So purchasing power parity is defined the number of units of a currency, number of units of a currency required to buy the some amount of goods and services in the domestic market, as $1 would buy in the US. Okay, the technique of purchasing power parity allow us to estimate what exchange between two countries is needed to express the accurate purchasing power of two countries. Okay, yes, purchasing power parity which we can purchase if any country. Okay, yes, simple example we talk about it. We will buy the mobile. Okay, yes, which we can purchase in any country. Okay, which we can purchase in India or any country, which we can purchase in India, the amount how much is equal to in the dollar. Okay, yes, how much it will be crossing the same amount in nearing country, Nepal. Okay, yes, and Sri Lanka. Okay, how much it will be given in China, how much it will be given in England, how much it will be given in Germany or Canada. Okay, so the amount the value that we can purchase equal to dollar is called purchasing power parity. Okay, do you clear? The respective country. Recently India became third large economy in the term of purchasing power parity. China became the largest, defeating the US to the second position. Okay, yes. Next we move on human development. Okay, yes, human development resource. Human resource is necessary for the progress of any country. Okay, yes, without involvement of human, no activity can be done. Okay, so without involvement of human, no activities can be done. Okay, yes, so human resource is necessary for the progress of any country. Okay, the term human resource refers to the collective abilities. So the term human resource refers to the collective abilities of people which can be utilized in the production sector. Okay, how can be utilized in the production sector. Okay, yes, human resource development means the development of persons' physical and mental abilities. Okay, through education, healthcare, and training. Okay, yes. Without education, we will not understand about anything. Okay, without proper training, we cannot do nothing. Okay, without practical knowledge, we will not do a particular activity. Okay, do you clear? Yes, that is what called what human resource development. Okay, yes, with a it give a progress and development of mental ability and physical ability through education, health care and training. Therefore, investment in education and health of people can result in high rate of returns in the future for a country. For example, if a child is invested with good education and health, he or she may turn to be very productive in future. Okay, in the form of higher earning and generating contribution to the society. So this is called human development. It is also called human development index, HDI. Okay, which indicates all round development of the people in the society. Okay, in the past, economists believed that the rate of economic growth of nation could be increased only by increasing investment in physical capital. Okay, economists believe what? Increasing investment in physical capital. Okay, so physical capital means nothing, that is in the property saved by money, building properties like buildings or flats, okay, jewels, they are the physical capital. Okay, but they have realized over time that investment in human capital is as important as investment in physical capital. Okay, so which is more important? Human resource development is more important than physical capital. Okay, so they realized over a time the investment in human capital is more important as investment in physical capital. Okay, do you clear? Yes, the Ministry of Human Resource Development is responsible for development of human resource in India. Okay, it headquarters is situated at Shastri Bhavan in New Delhi. Okay, yes, what is HDI? HDI means Human Development Index, which indicates all around development of people in the society. Okay, yes, HDI, Human Development Index, means that is nothing but life of human expectancy at birth and average education level plus standard of living. Okay, next we move on sustainability of development. Okay, sustainable means to survive to live. Okay, we need to keep up some resources, that is called sustainable development. Okay, sustainable economic development is taken to mean development without damaging in the environment and not compromising with the needs of future generation. Okay, the consequences of environmental degradation do not respect the national or state boundaries. Okay, sustainability of development is comparatively new area of knowledge in which scientists, economists, philosophers and other social scientists are working together towards sustainable. Okay, yes, we also learn about in this title about geography, natural resources means it can be divided into renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Okay, renewable resources are replenishable. Example, solar energy. Next, non-renewable resources are non-replenishable. Okay, example, minerals like coal, petroleum, these are okay. To achieve real sustainability, we need to balance economic, social, environmental and sustainability in equal harmony. In general, the question of development or progress is continuous. Okay, at all times, as a member of society and as individuals, we need to ask where we want to go, what we wish to become, and what our goals are. Okay, yes. The difference between renewable resources and non-renewable resources are, renewable resources are replenishable, that means we use the resources large. Okay, it can renew, it can be renew theirself. Okay, these are pollution free and environmental friendly. Okay, they take short time for the renewal. Okay, example, solar energy, wind energy and water. Okay, then non-renewable resources means these resources are non-replenishable, it cannot be renew itself. Okay, these resources, it pollute and damage the environment. Okay, million of years are needed for the formation of these resources. Okay, metals, glass, fossil fuels like coal, petroleum, natural gas. Okay, then here comes the parameter is till about 2011. Okay, literacy rate 2011, Tamil Nadu have 80.09 and India 74.04. Sex ratio in Tamil Nadu 996, okay, India 943. Enrollment of higher education 2015 to 16, Tamil Nadu 44.3 and India 24.5. Then we move on, policies for sustainable development. Okay, yes, India depends on thermal and hydropower plants to meet the power needs. Okay, both these resources have, okay, so India depends on thermal power and hydropower. Okay, with meets its power needs. Okay, both these resources are have adverse environmental impact. Thermal power plants emit large quantities of carbon dioxide. Okay, with it pollute the nature. Okay, and we move on, solar power in India. Solar power is the conversion of energy. Okay, solar power is the conversion of energy from sunlight into electricity, either directly using photovoltaic cells or indirectly using concentrated solar power. Okay, solar panels absorb the sunlight as a source of energy to generate electricity. Okay, yes, Tamil Nadu is the state with highest installed solar capacity in India. Tamil Nadu is one of the leading solar power producing state in India. As on 31st July 2017, the total installed capacity in Tamil Nadu is 1697 megawatt. Okay, then we move on. Environmental policies in India. Okay, India have been evolved considerable. Then we move on. Environmental policies in India have been evolved considerable over the past 3 decades. These policies have covered a wide range of issues such as air, water pollution, waste management and biodiversity conservations. Okay, India faces challenges in economic development which has to be achieved with limited resources, minimum externalities and in the presence of uncertain climate. One of the approaches to overcome these challenges is through the path of sustainable development. Supreme Court of India has interpreted and introduced new changes in environmental protection through a series of directions and judgments. According to Article 51A of the Constitution, states that it shall be the duty of every citizen of India to protect and improve the natural environment, including forest, lake, rivers and wildlife, and to have compassion for living creature. Okay, so the development increases the quality of life. Okay, development increases the quality of life. This means people will have higher income, better education, better health and nutrition, less poverty and more equality of opportunity. Okay, then we move on. List on environmental acts. National Green Tribunal Act 2010. Okay, the Environmental Protection and Conservation of Forest. Biological Diversity Act 2002 to provide for conservation of biological diversity. And third one, Environmental Protection Act 1986, it providing for the protection and improvement of the environment. Forest Conservation Act 1980, check deforestation and encourage afforestation and non-forest area. Okay, Forest Conservation Act 1980, it check the deforestation and encourage afforestation of non-forest area. Next, Water Preservation and Control of Pollution Act 1974 and Wildlife Protection Act 1972. Okay, all these act was enacted to prevent the environment. Okay students, we have discussed all the topic from this unit. Okay, before concluding we will see the recap lesson. We have learned in this lesson and talking about green economy, eradication of poverty and conserve the nature and to save our future. Okay, this lesson book back one mark is your homework today. Okay, and read out the lesson thoroughly and pronounce a new word correctly. Okay, we will see the next video. Thank you students.